even comrades. Yeah, I just want to say a few things on where we have come from, where we are, and where I think we should be going. If you recall the history of Kenya, and this goes to what the former CJ was sharing with us during the party, we also for him sometimes last month, should be added this month, 18th of this month. I think this country has gone through a number of phases in the search for a constitutional democracy. And I think to us, these are very critical because we had the pre-independence struggles where guys were just fighting for freedoms and independence. And that struggle was very clear. In fact, I attended another meeting in Arusha this week where we were coming up with a regional civil society initiative where guys were saying, we need to borrow from our freedom fighters as we come up with the new strongholds, because they were able to pick very, very few issues and package their campaigns around very strategic interventions. And the second phase, as you remember, it was after independence, up to the 1990s, where basically people were fighting for the political repression, which was caused by the post-independent regimes, and of course also for fundamental rights and freedoms, some of which had been properly entrenched in the Constitution of Kenya. And of course, from the 1990s up to 2010, we were agitating for what we used to call legal, political, institutional, and constitutional reforms, which of course we end up with a new constitution in August 2010. Then from there now, we have been in this phase of implementation of the constitution. And if you go through after 2010, you'll find that it's only the civil society, all the people and their agents for change who have remained faithful to this cause for a democratic constitution. But for the political elites, they have put in place mechanisms to ensure that either to weaken the constitution or to undermine its implementation. And if you look at today's newspaper, in page 10, the standard newspaper, there's an article by AfriCorp and KPTG. They did a study, which I thought it was supposed to be launched on Tuesday, from the letter we got from them. But the findings are very interesting, that over 82% of Kenyans don't think our leaders have been faithful when it comes to the implementation of the constitution. If you go through that, you'll find there's been a number of challenges when it comes to being faithful to the new constitution. But I think as a sector, we have tried to do our best through litigation, and you know the number of cases we have been able to pursue, legal and police actions, research and documentations, and also reflections of this nature. I remember the first one was held at Hilton Hotel in 2011, and from there, David has been gracious enough to host us at the Mazingira Institute. And David, also to thank you, because sometimes if you look at the way he organizes these kinds of events, it's not so expensive. And to us, this should be a lesson in terms of even how we conceptualize and also we plan our interventions. And also David, for also being faithful to the struggle from 1960s to date. And I think that's a very serious commitment to the cause for justice in the country. As a commission, as KHRC, this has been one of our major areas of interest. I remember for those who have worked for KHRC, the agenda for the new constitution has been added over from one generation to another. When I joined KHRC, I found Peter Kiama was the one in charge of constitution. He added that component to me. I ran with it up to post-bombers. When Tom joined us in 2006, you think there is, but the fight is too old. So, as we have picked a number of issues which are constitutional by nature, which we are going to pursue, especially on elections, security governance, civic space, because civic space is also the element of protection of the rights of protection and also assembly, and also equality issues, and also integrity, and also leadership, borders on corruption. But before I finish, I think that there are two things we may want to consider, given the development in the country. I think one of which, because we have moved from the agenda of civic education, we need to think about, and Greg can help us in this, because this is your mandate, how we can undertake radical political education to Kenyans to a proper understanding of the contents of this constitution, because sometimes we have faced many challenges where there are many contradictions on whether Kenyans, some of the sections of the society, really understood the contents of this constitution. And then finally, and it's something we have been discussing within KHRC and also with Kenya National Commission and other partners, to also do a legal audit of the emerging court decisions to see how things have been faring there, so that we can be able to establish the emerging jurisprudence when it comes to constitutionalism. And there's something else we have been thinking, which I don't think is very easy, but I think we can think about it. For example, also doing legal audit in terms of the emerging laws and the extent to which they have problem with the constitution. And I think the biggest problem is at counties, where county assemblies have been formulating completely unconstitutional laws and policies. I leave it at that, and welcome you to this great forum. And I think we should remain committed, so that come next year, we are here again to celebrate this great document. I thank you, and nakaribisha sana.